Hi, in this video I'll show how to use the Stackdriver Debugger, and I'll do this using a Node.js application on Google Container Engine. And let me first tell you what Stackdriver Debugger actually is. You can use it to do live debugging of applications without interruption. So if you have your Node.js application running on Container Engine, Kubernetes, then you can set breakpoints and it will capture state from your running application without the users noticing it. So you can have requests coming into your website all the time, and the breakpoint will capture one of those, and users won't notice any slowdowns or breaks like a normal debugger. And another nice thing you can do is you can add logs to running applications. So if you forgot to add logs to your application, or some specific bug shows up but you don't have logs for that particular part, just go to the source code and say, okay, I want to add a logging statement to this while it is running, so without redeploying it. And that's pretty cool. So let me show you how it works. Over here I have a Node.js application. It's pretty standard with a package.json for dependencies, and here the app.js we use Express. So if you talk about the Express part first, so you have Express and you say, okay, let me, if you do a GET request on the root, then you get the hello world. And other than that, we also have a health check. And we say, okay, listen on port 8080. And then the important part to get the cloud debugger working is this part at the top. We say, if we're running in production, then we require a Google Cloud debug agent. And we start it, and we say allow expressions true, which helps to be able to do expressions. I'll show you that in a second. So this is the Node.js application. Now the next thing, if we want to run this on Container Engine, we need Dockerfile, of course. So Dockerfile, we start with Node 8.4.0 based on Alpine. We say, okay, we actually run this in production, so this if statement that we used in the app.js is actually going to work. Then we say, okay, we're going to put the application in our app directory. We copy the package.json and the package log to that app directory. And then we npm install with production. So that gets the dependencies. And then after that, we copy our source code to the app source directory. And then there's an interesting thingy. We copy the source context JSON and source contexts with an S JSON also to the app directory. And those two files, they're specific to this debugger. So let me finish that in Docker part itself. So you expose port 8080 and you run Node.js. So this is pretty standard except for this line. So this line 11, this is sort of a source map or sort of a mapping of your source to the specific version that you're going to deploy. And let me show you how that works. So we have this command, gcloud beta debug source gen repo info file, and that generates a context file. So if I run this, then I get two files, and these two files are these kind of files. And basically what it says here is that, okay, the context of this application is this GitHub repository and this specific revision ID. So if I look at my Git, here I have in the source context, it says 2FAD88. And if I look at source tree, it says here 2FAD88. That's his last commit that I made, so that it can sort of reference this commit. So now when I deploy it, and let me actually make like a tiny change so it makes a new version. So hello world version 4. Okay, save that. Let me go to my changes. So I'll make a new commit from that. So now I'm gonna have version 4. Commit. Now when I create a new beta debug source, info files. Then if I look at them, it says now that I have a different revision ID. So now it knows, okay, this commit that I made now belongs to this version. So now if I deploy this version, let me make it a bit before. I'm gonna build the Docker container. So now the Docker container is built. I'm gonna push the Docker container to Google Cloud. There it is. And now I can change my Kubernetes deployment to use this new version. So 0.4 and deploy it. Okay, there we go. So see, now you can see that the debugging demo, the previous one is terminating, the new one is running, or is about to be running. Yeah, okay, so now it's running. So if I go to my browser and actually see if it's running there. Hello world version 4, okay, nice. So this new version is now running there. Now, because we added this requirement in our source, in our app.js, now we can use the debugger. So if we go to the website from the debugger, this consolecloud.google.com/debug. Let me reload that page. All right. Now we have these two versions here, and I'm not sure which one I need, so let me see. I have the EF6A and I have 38B0. Let me see which one it actually is. So I need the EF6A, that's the one I just created. So let's check that. That is this one, okay. And it knows that it's this one, and it gets the right source now based on this context file that I added before, and now we can see here version 4, that's the one I just created. Okay, so now I can see my source code here, and there are two cool things that you can do here. You can do snapshots and log points. And snapshots is basically like a normal debugger that you're kind of used to. So let me try that a bit. If I just add a snapshot here, I can just put a breakpoint here. So now whenever I hit the root URL, I'm gonna get a breakpoint here and I'm gonna get the state. So let's try that out. So I'm gonna reload this page and you'll notice that it's not gonna be blocking, it's going to return right away, but we do get a state. So let's see. So yeah, it returns right away. And now we have this snapshot here and I can actually click it open and see all the states and all the like a debugger, and I can just go through all these things and see what the values are. So that's pretty cool. But you also see that it's all kind of limited from what you can see. Like it only shows like the first, 10 or 15 fields. So in this case, for example, I want to see the headers from the request. Well, I can't actually see that here, but what I can do, I can type it here. All right, so now it's gonna specifically look for that expression. So if I hit it again, there we get it. And now I can see the request headers and it gives this whole value and you can see that I'm using Chrome with the user agent somewhere in here. So yeah, that way you can actually live debug and your users, they won't notice it because here you can just reload. It's just really fast and yeah, you can just debug without interruption there. So that's pretty cool. So that's a snapshot thing. So let me remove that. Where is the remove option? All right. What you can also do is log points. So now I specifically do this, I get one trace from this, but say I want to see it from every user, like, okay, somewhere something goes wrong, but I'm not really sure where, I can use a log point. So it basically dynamically adds a logging thing to your application. So for example, here, I want to add these headers for everybody. So in this case, I say, if true, then log point variable is blah, blah. So what I can say is, okay, headers is, and then I can use this accolades, require.request.headers, and. Okay, so now what it did is it made a log point, and it will say, okay, these are your headers when somebody actually hits this part. Let's try that out. So I'm going to hit the page again. Version 4. All right, and now we should have some logs. Let me see that in the logs viewer. So 10:44, that's right now. Okay, and there we indeed see the log point headers. So the headers we can see now here as a log. And these are just normal logs. So if I just get them through the command line, for example, like this, then we see the same log point here, and it's just standard output, and it just gives you more information here. So every time somebody hits this page, let me put a follow on that. You see requests coming in there. So that's pretty cool. For if your application, you always have these problems in your application, like, am I gonna put a whole bunch of logs in there and be able to see everything, but then get a lot of spam in my logs? Or am I only gonna log only the very critical things or the very big errors or something that I have to do something with, but miss everything else in case somebody else goes wrong and I don't know exactly what? And with this, you can go sort of in between. You can just log only the things that are really important. And then if you want to debug and have more information, you just go into the code and just dynamically add these log points. And I think that's a really cool thing to do. And it's for the Node.js environment, it's still a little bit beta. There are a couple of things that are not completely polished out yet, but I'm sure that will come soon. And it's also available for Go and for Java, and I'm thinking for Python as well. And for Ruby, it's also coming in beta. So it's pretty cool to play around with, and it's very, very powerful if you use this in production. So yeah, that's it.